We get in some more familiar territory with Lateralus, the 2001 album that Tool was able to deliver. This is a 5-year gap in between Anima and this disc, and once again we would have a 5-year gap between Lateralus and the album that would come after it, 10,000 Days. We know that we didn't yet have the jokes about how long it would be until the next Tool album was to drop, but now we had a Tool for the brand new millennium. We had a group that now had made the full evolution from a heavy metal group that really had instances of art and alternative laced within it with an album such as Undertow, to Anima really being the transition point into that more progressive setting, to now having that experimentation, that art, that progression, that alternative, that metal, all sort of coming, gelling, coalescing together, and perhaps becoming its own beast with Lateralus. I can still remember whenever Schism first came on the radio, which is the trademark track off of this album, though some may argue that Parable is better, or the title track is better, or this or that. That's just fandom. But Schism was the opening release that we were able to get from Lateralus. It was the first of the many sounds that we would hear based off this disc. And immediately, as a single, especially when considering 2001 radio, it was far and away different than each and everything that you listened to. Whenever you listened to the nuances of nu metal, which was now starting to reach its decline, whenever you were listening to some of the nuances of the other alternative rock or the Incubuses of the world, Breaking Benjamin's getting started a couple of years later or whatever, this was a group that immediately had a sound that did not fit the mold. Undertow, back in the day, in 1993, at least seemed to fit the mold of being counterculture or being different, because different was the flavor of the month. Now everything sounded a little bit similar, and Tool came out, and Schism was just far and away very, very different. It made you immediately know what it was. It gave you that instantaneous, brand. As much as I hate to use that word around Tool, but it was that brand recognition. You knew that Tool was different. And Lateralus proved that. And this is an album that starts off with long tracks to begin. We have The Grudge starting it off, which nearly eclipses the 9-minute mark, but not quite. And then we get into The Patient, which is 7 minutes. These are long songs. This is not something that the traditional consumer was fully used to whenever it came to nu metal and alternative, where most of the tracks, most of the cuts, hovered around the 3 to 4 minute mark. But then again, Tool fans, we knew what was up. We knew this was just the standard. But even then, it was starting to get a little bit longer, and they were starting to get a little bit more dynamic. The pieces were starting to get a little bit more ridiculous, but the pieces were also starting to fit, pun fully intended. With songs such as Schism and Parable really getting some big time play, and Parabola especially, considering that was the actual single, Parable was the lead up to it, this was just an album that felt like it had a different vibe to it, especially whenever you go back and listen to what Undertow and Anima was attempting to really create and craft. The songs and the sound have just evolved. Maynard's trademark vocals now were starting to become a little bit more muted, but then would come and rise like a phoenix rising from the ashes whenever necessary in order to create and craft the particular point that they were going for. The second half of this album got the song that actually really got me into Lateralus, which was Ticks and Leeches. I remember hearing this on digital music radio shortly after I heard Schism. I heard Schism and thought to myself, that's pretty cool, but I'm hearing that song an awful lot. I want to hear something else from this disc. Heard Ticks and Leeches about a week later and was sold instantaneously. And little did I know that directly after this, you're going to have the epic title track Lateralus, which was nearly 10 minutes by itself. But then directly after that, you have a trilogy of songs, one of which, Reflection, is more than 10 minutes. It's 11:04. This is a long disc, ladies and gentlemen. But it's also filled with a lot of solid, solid material that hook you with this band. Now, I know that I said in the last video that Anima may have been sort of the secret, the crafty, the sort of hidden masterpiece in Tool's discography. And I think that's mostly because a lot of folks see Lateralus as perhaps the true one, as perhaps the true masterpiece of Tool's limited discography. And part of this is no doubt because it helped birth a second generation of Tool fans. Those that weren't on board before, that heard this group alongside the others on the radio, whenever Schism would drop or Parabola would drop, immediately knew and recognized how different this was. And if they latched onto it, they ended up enjoying it. there's definitely a bit of a similarity or a bit of a handshake between Tool and stoner culture. You just have to throw that out there just a little bit. If you're a stoner and you don't like Tool, a lot of other stoners are probably wondering what's wrong with you. This is probably one of the bands that stoners most like to enjoy, or at least those that I've known. I hate to generalize, but it does seem like they would go hand in hand. The visualization and the style was going apeshit crazy at this point. We're talking a lot of great visuals. We're talking about philosophical lyrics, songs that are saying the word math. I mean, the one thing that you don't really see or hear in music is discussions about math. And when it happens, it's usually just a passing moment. But Tool sometimes feels like a complex equation on this album. Lateralus itself feels like a formula that is supposed to somehow show you the inner workings of the earth or the prevalence of your own destiny. Either that or just letting us know how badly we're being screwed. This is a great album, and this is one that I think deserves a lot of the accolades and the praise that it gets. Although at the time, whenever it was a couple of years after its release, it did start to get a little irritating. This was probably Tool at their most saturated point, where more and more folks were getting involved, where more and more folks were latching on to them, where that fan base was growing to a fever pitch, and from here on out, they were no longer just a cult classic band. From here on out, they were a major league product. 5 years it took between Anima and Lateralus, 5 years it would take between Lateralus and 10,000 Days, which prior to this coming Friday, with the release of Fear Inoculum, was the last album from Tool that we had. It's amazing to think that the whole history of this YouTube channel passed by nearly never getting the opportunity to talk about a brand new Tool record. But let's talk about 10,000 Days next, and I hope that you'll stay with me in order to do that. I'm Cover Killer Nation, and I'll see you then.